everybody, welcome back to episode 1 of Pokemon Sun and Moon. Today I'm playing Pokemon Sun, and yeah, this is something different. You guys are usually used to Minecraft. I've done some Pokemon things in the past, but today I'm going to make a Pokemon Sun and Moon Let's Play. I'm playing Pokemon Sun, I've already played Pokemon Moon, and I decided I wanted to play Sun on YouTube after I've played it on my own first. I like to do that with games, I like to play them on my own, and now I'm going to make a YouTube series on it. I know I'm a little late. I'm like a little bit more than a week late. Came out a week ago. But I hope you guys enjoy. So, we have Professor Kukui here. And he is on, I guess, our computer. And it says, hang on now. Give me just a sec. Hey there. Good afternoon. So, the day has finally come that you're moving to Alola. Alola is a region made up of several islands. That could be the reason the region is chock full of nothing but rare Pokemon, yeah? There's no shortage of cool Pokemon out here in Alola, either. Such mysterious creatures. You find them all over. In the grass, in the caves, in the sky and sea. Depend on them heaps, too. Some of us even battle with them if we call ourselves Pokemon trainers. Rockruff, can you wait till I'm done talking to play? Alright, I gotta ask you some questions about yourself, so I can introduce you to everybody. So which photo should I use for your trainer passport? Alright, I guess I'll just choose this one. Alright, yes. Alright, now I gotta spell out my name. I'll just name myself Chris. I'm pretty sure that's what I named myself on Pokemon Moon as well, so I'll do the same here. Alright, oh, you guys can't see the bottom screen. I forgot about that. Sorry about that. You guys can't see the bottom screen because I don't have a capture card. I know the quality's not the best, but maybe one day I'll get a capture card or something like that. But for now, bear with me here. I'm sorry, but this is the best I can do. So, 10-4, good buddy. I don't know what that means. I'll let everybody out here know you're on your way. Chris. Yeah, that's a name that hits you like a thunderbolt out of the sky. Woo! Can't wait to see you in person then, cousin. Okay, so throughout the whole game he calls you cousin, because I've played it before. I don't know if you're actually his cousin or not, or if he's just calling you that, like, pal or friend. I'm not sure about that, I don't know. Chris, come help me with these boxes. Alright, so I guess we have a magazine about Alola, it looks like, in our room. And it looks like now we have to go help somebody with the boxes. Our mom, I think. Oh, okay, this is like a cool cutscene. Alright. I actually missed this the first time I'm playing. I missed a little bit of this, so. Alright. Ooh, she's running from them. Oh, that doesn't seem good. Alright, Pokemon Sun, that's a cool intro to the game. Alright, let's get started here. 3 months later. So I guess this is 3 months after all that happened, where she was running away from them. Alright. So, this is Melee Island. I'm pretty sure that's how you say it, not 100% sure. Like I said, I played the game already, that's how I know. But yeah, I'm not good with pronouncing names and stuff like this if I don't know them, so I'm gonna say a lot of the names probably wrong. Even a Pokemon, I'm not sure. So yeah. Alright, this is our house right here. Alright. So let's get started here. This is a really good game. It's like my favorite Pokemon game I've ever played when I played Pokemon Moon. So I know it's gonna be good. Ah, can't you just feel the warmth? That warmth? The first day spent under Alola's sun. It's so warm and bright here. But that's enough of that. Time to unpack all these boxes. Meow. Go get Chris for me, would you? Okay, this is Meow. Alright, so, in the game, your mom has a regular Meowth. If you've seen the trailers for Pokemon Sun and Moon, there's an Alolan Meowth that you can get in Alola. So that's really cool. I guess in the game, your mom has a regular Meowth because you're from Kanto. So it's just like, you're coming from Kanto, and so she's had her Meowth. So that's why it's regular. But you cannot get a regular Meowth here. There's an Alolan Meowth, which for those of you who don't know, looks a little bit different. It's like grayish, bluish, grayish kind of thing. And there's an Alolan Persian. They both look a little bit different. And you can't get this Meowth in this region. Alright, so the first time I played this for like a few seconds, I was just like sitting here like, when is he going to get up? You have to actually like walk out of the bed yourself. I didn't realize that the first time I played this. So, yeah. Alright, so Meowth came and woke us up. That was rude. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, so we're going downstairs. No. In this game, you don't go downstairs. No. In this game, it's one floor. And finally, There are more rooms, not just two rooms now. You were out like a light, weren't you? You ought to be full of energy by now. So, Chris, are you pumped to meet some Alolan Pokemon? Of course. Alright. That's right. I want to hurry up and meet some, too. We're living in the Alola region now, the beautiful islands everyone wants to visit. I'm sure the Pokemon living in a place like this must be friendly, right? There's the doorbell. Was that the doorbell? It's gotta be Professor Kukui. Why don't you let him in, Chris? Alright. So, let's go right around here. Sorry, I keep accidentally moving the DS. It's just, yeah. I keep accidentally moving it because when I click the buttons and stuff, I'm accidentally, like, pushing it. Hey there, Chris. The name's Kukui. Good to meet you, cousin. You gotta be tired after that long trip all the way out here to Alola. You feeling any jet lag? We sure are a long way from Kanto out here in Alola. It's still daytime out here, yeah. Professor Kukui, yes, we just arrived yesterday. Hey there, Mom. I just let myself in. Oh, and call me Kukui, would you? Welcome to Alola. Of course, I still remember seeing you in the Indigo battle, the Indigo leader, gym leaders back in Kanto all those years ago. You know, I've been in love with Alolan Pokemon ever since, so I finally decided to come here myself. Huh? I was supposed to be visiting there to research Kanto Pokemon moves and all. I thought I knew a thing or two about battling, but those Kanto gym leaders proved me wrong. Hey now, Chris. Let's gonna move on to the next town over, cousin. Time for you to meet the island Kahuna and get yourself a Pokemon, yeah? Pokemon? Wait, no, why did I ask that? Alright. Yeah, sure, the Kahuna who lives in Iki Town is always happy to give any kid who wants to have an adventure their first Pokemon, yeah? Why does he always say yeah at the end of a sentence? I don't understand that. But don't try taking on the Kahuna yourself. The Kahunas are crazy strong Pokemon trainers. They're unbeatable for folks like you and me. They'll simply give my boy a Pokemon? Then those Kahunas really are worth meeting. Hurry and get ready, Chris. Your bag and things are still in the boxes in your room, I think. And didn't you leave your copy of Adventure Rules on your desk in there, too? Oh, I bet you got a silent hat that'll match mine, yeah? Alright, so, yeah, we have to go get our starter Pokemon. I think I'm going to choose Litten. That's the fire type one, for those of you who don't know. But, yeah. Alright, let's go over here. Adventure Rules. Alright. That's Adventure Rules over there. I'm not even going to read them because, yeah. Alright, here's a box. We checked out the moving boxes and pulled the bag and hat. There we go. Alright, let's see. Now we look like a trainer. We got our hat and our bag. We look like a trainer now. Alright. Alright, so let's get going. We have to get our starter Pokemon. That's going to be really fun. The starters of this game are all really cool, but last game, when I played Pokemon Moon, I chose Rowlet. Now I want to choose Litten. So, yeah. You look ready for anything now. Have a good time out there. I'll be sure to have everything cleaned up and put away by the time you come back with your new Pokemon. Ooh, that's a styling hat, cousin. Alright. Okay, I just want to get going. There's so much text in this game. Alright. Your mom there. She's sure looking forward to you getting your first Pokemon, yeah? So let's get going to Iki Town. Time for you to get a real nice Pokemon from the Island Kahuna. Oh, yeah. Alright. I forget exactly where he is. I'm pretty sure Iki Town is, like, right down the road. But, yeah. We'll get one. Alright, so we're going to get our starter Pokemon. I'm going for Litten because, I don't know, he's probably my second favorite of the three. I don't know. I like all of them, though. I think they're all really cool Pokemon. But, yeah, I'm just going to go for Litten. Alright, let's get going. I think it's this way. I mean, this is the only way you can go. And he stops you again. I just want to get by him. Alright, that's more like it, yeah? Welcome to Paradise, cousin. This is the Alola region. Folks here in Alola get along by living together with Pokemon and working hard. My phone's low on battery. Alright, sorry about that. After all, you can go anywhere as long as you got your Pokemon helping you out here. Okay. That's why we gotta get you to the Kahuna. First, we're off to Iki Town. Come on, it's not far if we cut up here. Alright, so. Alright, let's get going up here. So, the first town. Alright, we're on Route 1 right now, which I don't think has any tall grass since, you know, we don't have any Pokemon yet. Yeah, it's just Route 1 with some trainers on it that you don't even battle because, again, you don't have a Pokemon yet. So, how would you battle when you don't have a Pokemon? So, Chris, you're living all already, yeah? Yeah. That's what I like to hear. Alright, I'm skipping this at this point. Alright. Alright, Professor Kukli, you gotta recommend another move for me sometime, please. Why? You already know which moves you want to use, yeah? You come find me next time your Pokemon learns a new move, and then I'll battle you. Alright. Oh, wow. The person has a Pikachu already? I want a Pikachu. I probably won't get a Pikachu this game, though, since I had it when I played Pokemon Moon. I want to try to get different Pokemon. See that? If you had a Pokemon with you, you could dive into the tall grass here, yeah? To try to catch some wild Pokemon to add to your team. Well, don't rub it in, Kukui, that I don't have a Pokemon yet. Alright, so. Alright, then trainers go up against one another in battle with the Pokemon they love. Come on, young goose. Hiss, I don't even know how to say that. There's no I in the middle of H and S. Whatever, okay. How's it? You're the new kid that just flew in. Let's have a Pokemon battle sometime. Having Pokemon gives you a whole new way to communicate with other people, see? Now let's get moving. Iki Town is right over there. So, the first island is probably the easiest. Well, not probably. It is the easiest of the three. I'm pretty sure there's only one trial. Trials are basically the replacements of gyms, kind of. For those of you who played other Pokemon games. Not Pokemon Go, but other Pokemon games are gyms. I guess there are gyms in Pokemon Go, but they're different than the gyms in other Pokemon games. But yeah. This town is where folks come to worship the Pokemon that watches over Mele Mele Island. Tapu Koko keeps us all safe and happy. See? Okay, so Tapu Koko is one of the island guardians. He, like, guards this island. So, yeah. Huh? What's going on here? We were supposed to meet everybody right here, yeah? Maybe they're all back on Mahalo Trail. That's where the ruins of the guardian deity Tapu Koko are, yeah? Chris, do me a solid and go find the Island Kahuna. I'll wait around here to make sure we don't miss each other. The Island Kahuna? You can't miss him. He looks just like a kahuna. I guess that's supposed to be a joke, because I don't think anybody knows what a kahuna looks like. I don't even know. Well, obviously I know because I played the game, but the first time I had no idea what he was going to look like. At all. Oh, that's the person from the video. Really? You want to go up to the ruins? I don't know what you hope to find there. Yeah, so I play Pokemon Moon, so I already know what's going to happen. But, yeah, I'm playing through it again because this is an amazing game. I definitely recommend it. If you don't have it, I definitely recommend you get it because it's really fun. It's a really interesting game. And if you've only played Pokemon Go, you should definitely try a real Pokemon game. So you should try this one because, yeah, this one's probably the best one I've ever played. I like every Pokemon game, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I'm pretty sure every Pokemon game I've played I've liked, unless I'm forgetting about some. But, yeah, this one's probably my favorite out of all of them. Alright. You can't come out. We'll get in trouble if anyone sees you. Alright, so she has a Pokemon in her bag. And that Pokemon is powerful. Alright, let's go up here. This place was in the demo. In the Pokemon Sun and Moon demo, you could go in there and stuff. The demo was only like 5 minutes long, though. There wasn't much stuff in the demo. But the real game is a lot better than the demo was. Alright. That's her Pokemon. That's Cosmog. And Cosmog is flying across there. And Spearows are going to come attack it. So we don't have a Pokemon yet. We can't help. Sadly. I want to fight off those Spearows, but we can't. Later on, we'll be able to get that Pokemon, Cosmog. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can get it. Yeah. And that will be awesome when we do get it. Because I really like Cosmog. That's Cosmog, that Pokemon that she has. It's a really cool Pokemon, in my opinion. Even though it's, like, it's not the most powerful Pokemon, but it is really cool. Like, in battle, it's not powerful. But it is a powerful Pokemon. I don't want to spoil too much, though. I'll say, who are you? Even though I know. Never mind me. You have to help it, please. Save Nebby. So, yeah, that's what she nicknamed her Cosmog, Nebby. So, later on when I got my Cosmog in Pokemon Moon, because you do get one, you could catch it. I think that's kind of obvious. You could, because you usually get every Pokemon. There's pretty much, I think you could get every single Pokemon. In every Pokemon game, I don't know if there's a Pokemon you can't get. Unless it's like from an event, or if it's glitched or something. I don't know. Anyway, I'm pretty sure there's a way to get every single Pokemon. And yeah, so you can get Cosmog, because, yeah, and I nicknamed mine Nebby because, yeah, well, why not? Alright. Oh, wow, that's sad. These Spearows are mean. Why do they always just, why do they attack people? I'm pretty sure in the anime they attacked Ash. I'm pretty sure they're supposed to be, like, vicious birds or something. Alright, and Cosmog blew up and broke the bridge. Oh, what's that? Tapu Koko is here to save the day. So before you fall in the water, we're saved. Alright, that's good. And he flies off. So that is the island guardian for this island, Tapu Koko. Like, it's the guardian, so... Yeah, you get to catch him later. He's probably... my favorite one is the third island one, which you'll see eventually, because I'm going to make a video about how to get it eventually. You tried using your power again, didn't you? Oh, Nebby, you know what happened last time you used it. You couldn't move for ages after that. I don't want to see you like that again. No, I shouldn't say that. I'm sorry, Nebby. I know you were trying to save me that time, and I couldn't even help you in return. Pew. It always says pew. I don't know why, but it does. What? What is that? Ooh, found something. Pew pew. A sparkling stone? It feels almost warm somehow. Please forgive me. I am so grateful to you for helping us out of that dangerous spot. And I'll say, who are you? Again. I'm pretty sure that's the second time. I think this stone must belong to you. You obtain the sparkling stone. You might notice it looks like a Z-ring. All right. Please, don't tell anybody about this, about seeing Nebby. It's a secret, okay? Come on, into the bag, Nebby. It's kind of creepy that she just, like, keeps it in the bag. Like, I know it's to protect the Pokemon, but, like, I find it a little bit, like, odd that she does that. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. Right. I'm worried we might get attacked again by some wild Pokemon or something. I know it's too much for me to ask it, but do you think you could see us back to town? Alright, so now we're going to go back. And once we get our starter, I think I'll end off this episode because it's already been 19 minutes. So. Hey, Chris, looks like you missed the kahuna, yeah? But you found my assistant, oh yeah. Looks like you already met, but just in case, this is my assistant. Oh, yes, you can call me Lily. And Lily, this here is Chris. He just moved here from Alola. I mean, to Alola. Take good care of him. So, you're also the one of the... You're also one of the professor's acquaintances. It's nice to meet you. Alright, so now... The Kahuna is back! Kahuna Hala has returned! Our guardian's chosen one is back! Only the only one of the strongest Pokemon users in all Alola, yeah? Okay. Here he is. That's the Kahuna. His name's Hala. Kahuna Hala. And, I'm pretty sure he's pretty hard to beat at the end when you have to battle him. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna have to battle him when we're done with this island. Have I missed something? No, but where'd you go off to, Kahuna? I thought we were meeting here. I am the Kahuna of this island after all. Whenever there's a problem on the island, it is my duty to resolve it. Sorry, Lily. What were you saying before? For some reason, I thought I saw Tapu Koko flying about. Yes, Kahuna Hala. Nebby was being attacked by Spearow on the plank bridge when this boy helped me. But the bridge collapsed, and I thought both of them might fall to the bottom of the ravine, and that was when the island's guardian deity swooped in to save them. Ooh, that's something you don't hear every day. Oh, although it is said to protect us, our Tapu Koko is a rather fickle creature. Yet our guardian was moved to save you. Kukui, my boy, I think we have cause to celebrate. It seems I should entrust this brave and kind young boy with a Pokemon of his own. We'll make a fine trainer out of him. I'm glad to meet you, child. I am Hala, the Kahuna of Mele Mele Island. Welcome to Kahuna. Young Kukui had told me of your coming. I'm glad we got the chance to meet today. Come, my Pokemon. Let's have a look at you. Alright, time to choose my starter. I'm going to choose Litten, which is the one in the middle. Litten's like a fire kitten. So, let's choose Litten. First is the grass-type Pokemon Rowlet. Cool. Next is the fire-type Pokemon Litten. And last is the water-type Pokemon Popplio. Alright. So, alright, we're going to choose... Alright, Litten, the fire-type Pokemon, is going to be our starter. Yes. Okay, so that is the beginning of our adventure in the Alola region. If you did enjoy this video, please leave a like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and bye, everyone. Okay, so now, there's just like this cutscene right here. So... Let us see if little Litten here, there also decides to choose you. Alright, come on, Litten. Choose me. I'm pretty sure they choose you no matter what. Wouldn't that be funny, though, if, like, they didn't choose you sometimes? Like, if it's like, nope, you gotta choose another starter, they don't like you. Alright. Yeah, that would be kind of sad, though, too, because, like, I wanted Litten. That makes you choose a different one. And, alright, so Litten likes me. Alright, so, yeah, Litten looks really cool. Oh, it's so cute. Litten looks cute. Alright. Oh, so, little Litten has accepted you as well, Chris. Having accepted one another, you'll surely be friends for life. Alright, I'm not gonna give him a nickname. I don't really do that usually. Unless, like, I named Cosmog Nebby, because, you know, that's Lily's nickname for it. But, yeah, usually I don't do that. The nickname thing. Nice to meet you, Litten. Oh, when did you get out again? I know that Kahuna Hala and the professor will keep you safe from any harm, but you should still stay in the bag and out of sight. It's safer that way. I think you chose a wonderful Pokemon. Please take very good care of it. That's it, Chris. Now that you've got a Pokemon, you're a real Pokemon trainer, yeah? And there's a lovely gift from me to help make it special, cousin. And then you get the Pokédex. A Pokédex is a real high-tech kind of tool, yeah? That can automatically record facts about any Pokémon that you meet. Your new partner, Litten, is already registered, oh yeah, so check it out. And this is a trainer passport that I have put together for you. Now, why don't you go introduce your new friend to your mom, Chris? Alright, so we are going to save our game there so nothing gets deleted. And I'm going to end this episode for today. For real this time, I'm ending the episode. So if you did enjoy this video, please leave a like and subscribe. If you want to see more of Pokemon Sun and Moon videos, just tell me that in the comments section. And when I'm done with the full story, I will also make videos on like how to get things, like how to get Tapu Koko and how to get Tapu Bolu and all the other Tapu Pokemon, the Guardian Deity things, and all the legendaries and everything like that. So, yeah, if there are any of those specifically that you do want to see, also comment about that, because eventually I'll make videos about that, and I might look back here and see which ones you guys want me to show in a video. So, thanks for watching, and bye, everyone.